Well, you've seen the painting that I'm beginning to work on. I want to show you now the palette. I'm using titanium white, ultramarine blue, burnt sienna, yellow ochre pale, and cadmium yellow light. I've selected this palette because I thought it would give me the tonality I need, the mixtures I would need for the painting that I'm going to do. Here's the sketch. My color studies over here, and this is placed under a clear acrylic, a sheet of acrylic, so that I'll mix up the colors I want, and I will place them on this acrylic sheet here to make sure that I match the values and the tonality of this color study. And that's how the painting will be completed. So I will show you the process as I go through. Hope this is helpful. Okay, I have the panel covered. I prefer working this way where I can see the total piece rather than working one area at a time and developing it fully before moving on. I just need to see the whole thing. So what you're seeing here is a very thin application of paint, but I got the panel totally covered. A couple of real important lessons that might be helpful to you is if you've created a study beforehand, it is really important that you trust the colors and the values and the temperature of that color that you created in the study, because when those colors are applied to the panel, they do not look right. They may look too dark, they just don't feel like what the study looks like. But in the context, when you get the whole panel covered like I did here, then everything fits in its place properly. But there were many doubts throughout the creation of this block in here that that color is not right. And yet I would go back and check it on my study because I had that clear acrylic sheet laid over the study itself. So I could mix right on my palette and apply those mixtures right on top of that clear acrylic. And I knew that I was matching the colors of my study perfectly. So I had to trust that. I had to trust those mixtures and go ahead and put them down on this panel and not worry about the fact they didn't look right on the panel itself. And the other lesson I learned is that I work, or another lesson that should be applied is don't just jump all over the canvas and put the mixtures in. I work one area next to the other, the adjacent area, and I kept building, as you saw in the stills that are included in this video. I worked one area, then worked the area right adjacent to it. And that's a good method to use because I'm able to judge not only the value, the color and the color temperature relative to what was already put down prior to that. So it was real important that I work step by step. You also notice I began in the foreground, which is the focal point. My darkest darks are there. And so that's where I started. And then I built to the background. So I hope this is helpful. Now the next stage will be, I will start at the sky and start working my way forward now and develop each area as I go. Well, the painting is slowly progressing. It's really important that I maintain these different degrees of veil of atmosphere as we go back. And just now I've pretty much got it done to this point, but I want to see the painting when it's totally completed to see if it can be adjusted. This background hill is very difficult to accomplish. I probably rubbed it out 7 or 8 times. There's just a little bit of color in it, the slightest amount. I'm not sure it's totally where it needs to be. I also changed up the barn here, made it a little more interesting barn than what I originally had. Added this house over here to kind of add to the story that, okay, these two things probably belong to one another. I'm down now to this point in the painting, just this foreground part. And I've just started now, you can probably see it, to add some texture. Just a slight amount of texture as the painting is coming forward. We're starting to see now, we would in real life even, we're able to see a little more texture. And this is not where it needs to be yet. I've just kind of started on this part. But this is where the important part of the painting is going to be taking place. All these foreground grasses here are going to be overlapping some of this. So I've got to get this right before I work on this part. And I want to integrate some of these tan colors, really light grays, and these greens mesh, intermingle them in and through that so that you're actually seeing through this pile of weeds. And when I get this part done, then I will start on this part and work through to my focal point, which is over here. And then of course I've got all the road to do, the texture and all that in there. This particular painting was pretty, I had to do that probably 3 times. These trees I had a little bit darker and they tended to come forward into the painting, in fact onto the same plane as this, and yet in the painting they are farther back than this group of trees. So I had to subdue those and work on that several times to get them so they felt like they were pushed back. So the difficulty of this painting is maintaining these veils of atmosphere. And you have to be careful, and it required a lot of standing back and making sure everything stayed in its proper place. Everything is really very grayed as you go back in the distance, getting a little more rich color as we come forward. There won't be any rich color, you know, totally saturated color in this painting. This will obviously be the brightest part of the painting. But I'm going to continue now to work on this part. And as I get over here, I may show you a little bit of my painting as I work on that part. So thank you. And I'll be back as we proceed through the painting. Thank you. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. It was quite a process and took some time to be able to complete it. The important thing, of course, was to maintain that feeling of atmosphere. You know, when you saw at the beginning the original photograph I worked from, so it was real important to keep in view the whole, not just bits and pieces of this painting. So I had to really be careful all the way through the process that I maintained that feeling, those veils of atmosphere. And so when I came to the foreground, I wanted to make sure that I had more detail. It was a little more clear, in other words, in sharper focus and more color. So it was, I had to stand back quite a bit to make sure that everything stayed in its place and looked proper. But it was a challenge to do this painting just because of the difference between the original photograph I worked from and this idea, which was really from imagination. So I hope you enjoyed it. It was a long process, and I had to set the painting aside for quite some time just to come back to it with fresh eyes and to areas that I thought, for instance, this looks terrible, I'm going to have to repaint this whole area. And then as I came back later and viewed it, I thought, you know, yeah, this works. It fits in its proper place. There's just the right amount of detail and all that stuff. So I was able to leave it. But in the midst of the process, I felt, you know, this is just not coming together. So it is good sometimes to stand back, set your painting aside, and come back to it with a clear eye, at a different time, so that you can view it a fresh eye. So anyway, I hope you found this video helpful, and we'll do some more. And anyway, thank you for joining me on this. I just hope it was beneficial to you. Thank you.